bullying in Japan is actually quite concentrated, quite focused. Virtually all of the bullying occurs in middle school. Almost all of the bullies are male. Somewhere between 2/3 and 80% of all the bullies are male. It happens mostly in the second and third year of middle school. And it's a very interesting pattern. The bullies, most of the concentration in Japan in Japanese literature is on the students who are bullied, the targets. And there are some dark personalities. There's some people who don't fit in. You've all heard the sort of thing about the nail that sticks up gets hammered down. The idea of bullying is the Japanese system hammering down nails, making people fit in a form. Recently, there's been some very interesting looking at the bullies, not the bullied. And it turns out that the bullies tend to be kids who, at this point in their lives, I say tend, because there's a whole range of psychological disorders occurring in child and so on. But the underlying injury, somewhere in here, kids kind of figure out, are you going to make the first team or not? Are you going to go to your fighting chance of doing this or not? All of this back here, this is what high school you're going to go to. The kids who do the bullying tend to be kids who are not going to get to the elite high schools, are not going to be competitive. Now remember, we're going to talk about this more later, but remember, Japan has what's called an educational meritocracy. That is, your status in life is heavily, heavily influenced by your formal education. If you have a degree from Toda, it is worth much more than a degree from East Horrible Prefectural University. In the United States, this is true to a certain extent. Harvard is still Harvard. But in the United States, there's a lot of competition for Harvard. The American pile is much more like this. The Japanese pile is much more like this. Much, much more hierarchical in Japan. Okay? And it turns out that these students are students, the bullies tend to be students who are not so good, who would not be so confident, not going to succeed. The ones who get beat up tend to be ones who are going to be very successful, and sort of publicly so. So what you get in a Japanese middle school, this is, I'm just reading the literature, I've never been to a Japanese, I've never gone to school in a Japanese middle school. They won't let me in my 30s go to school. Kids start being very careful not to show off. You don't want to be the nail that sticks up, because you're going to get hammered. This is also true in Korea. Very careful that you act like everybody else, which in effect reinforces, I think, their sort of more or less natural teenager tendencies to try and blend in. Teenagers try to fit in. In this case, it makes it much, much harsher. The bullying can be quite severe. There are cases of kids driven to suicide. There are cases of kids who are actually murdered. There's one case a couple years ago, a kid who was backed up with gymnastics mats, basically suffocated. And they knew what they were doing. They were trying to kill him. Which is a little rough. And this is seen as being connected somehow to the stress of the Japanese system. I have a hard time with that argument because I see bullying in the United States where you have a much, much less high pressure system. Why you have a Columbine, I have no idea why you have a Columbine. Columbine, for those of you who don't know, is a famous American case where there was a shooting in high school. And 11 kids were killed? 15? So a lot of people were shot in a fairly short time. And I've never heard anything parallel to that in Japan. Okay, there's a blaming the family that goes on, etc. There's another thing that happens in Japan that you get, which is a variation of school refusal. Hikikomori. My staff have highly trained Japanese speakers. Hikikomori, which is a psychological problem for children who just retreat to their rooms. But this one is very simple, because as far as I know, hikikomori only occurs in Japan. It is a culturally based disease. Now, this is not unique, but there are many culturally based diseases. Actually, my favorite in Japan is goju kata, 50-year shoulders, which is a stiffening of the shoulders where people really can't lift their hands beyond this point. It lasts for a couple of years and then it goes away. As far as I know, it occurs nowhere else in the world except Japan.